Welcome back to Fox 5 Morning News. On this Friday morning, this weekend, the USA Dance National DanceSport Championships are going on in Baltimore.
And this morning, Holly Morris is there to preview the event and see what it takes to be one of the best dancers in the country. And apparently, it doesn't matter how old you are. Those are the cutest little dancers behind you.
Oh my gosh, too cute for words. Don't you just want to grab them and
eat
them up? I know. We have just been enjoying them, watching them rehearse here this morning. But these are not even just some of the best dancers in the country. Some of them literally are the top dancers in the world. They have competed on the world level. And it just gives you an idea of how important this particular competition is. It's in Baltimore this year. It won't be next year. So this is your chance to come out and really see something special. Peter Pover is the president of USA Dance, and he joins you this morning. Good morning to you.
Good morning to you, Holly.
Thank you so much for allowing us to be here. This is wonderful.
We're delighted to have you.
Tell me a little bit of, literally, about the magnitude and the importance of this weekend and this competition.
Well, this is our biggest national championship ever. It's the one that we use to select not only our national champions, but for our international style events, those couples who will represent us in world championships in different countries all over the world in the next 12 months. And we've got over 1,100 people here dancing, all ages, from 7 to well into their 70s.
It really shows that you can dance for your entire life at a very high level.
Absolutely. And this evening, we're honoring three of our members who are in their 90s.
Wow, that is just such an inspiration. Kind of tell me how the weekend's going to work as far as the categories and the competitions.
Well, they would spread out over the 3 days. The big events, tonight we have the Adult Latin Championships, and we have some very good competitors there, including the younger brother of Max Chmielkowski,
wow,
who's dancing with the stars. Val will be dancing. Tomorrow night, we will have the amateur standard or modern ballroom competition. And then we will decline a little bit on Sunday. But at the end of the competition, we've got team matches from all regions all over the country. And we're going to be going from 8 o'clock every morning till after midnight, non-stop.
Serious dancing.
Crazy.
Crazy cutting a rug, I'm telling
you. I'm tired already.
Yeah, I hear you. And you brought up Dancing with the Stars. Because of shows like that, have you seen just a surge in popularity?
Not a major surge. A small surge, yes. But what we have found is recognition. My other sports, golf. Saturday mornings on the tee, I used to say, you know,
yeah,
I'd dance and people would go, yeah, right. Now I get on there and they say, who's going to win this year?
Right,
and they're not talking about the Super Bowl.
That's wonderful. Well, I want to check in with a couple of the dancers here. And I wanted to kind of point out, you see the young dancers. This is a family. Mom and Dad are over here. This is the Campos family. There's Mom and Dad. And then little Cara here in the red hot number. She's only 9. She was on one of the seasons of Dancing with the Stars. And then we have Craig and Samantha here. You might recognize them because they won the junior championships on Dances with the Stars. They're 14th and 11th. So the family that dances together stays together. All right. Craig and Samantha, can I cut in here for a second? All right. So how did you guys get started dancing?
Well, we got started dancing by our mom.
Mm-hmm.
Because I saw her at the party, and then I was sitting down. So I started dancing with someone else, and I decided, can I try dancing? Because I don't want to keep sitting down.
That is so fun. And, you know, for young people like you, you're at such a high level. What do you really get out of this?
Well, what we really get out of this is, like, all the hard work that we do and all the cooperation that me and my brother do.
Who's better, your brother or you?
Both of us.
Look at that. That is brother and sisterly love. Can you do a little something for us?
Yeah, sure.
What are you going to do?
A cha-cha.
All right. So here is the cha-cha from 9 and 11-year-old Craig and Samantha. You can see why they won Dancing with the Stars, the junior championship. And of course, they're going to be competing this weekend along with other elite dancers out here at the Renaissance Harbor Place Hotel. It is the USA Dance National DanceSport Championship. They do have general admission tickets, though I will tell you, tickets are going fast, so you need to get them now. Coming up in our next hour, we're going to have a little Lexan with the Foxtrot, and we're going to talk to some more couples that are going to be competing. Back to you guys.
And we are in. They are really good.
Wow.
I know. Thanks, Holly.
Okay, and a reminder, they're not the only dancers out there. Holly will also be in this weekend's production of Chicago, the musical, at the National Theater. We saw her remote where she was giving us a little preview of it, but she will actually take the stage in the production Sunday during the 2 p.m. matinee. Holly will perform in three scenes, as one of the women incarcerated in the Cook County Jail. For ticket information, among others, for ticket information, you can go to myfoxdc.com. Look under web link. So we are real proud of her. Mm-hmm. For doing